Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. After all the love I have received from uploading the video on chicken tikka masala, today I am back with a similar one but this time with the mushrooms. It is mushroom tikka masala, and if you are fond of mushrooms, you must give this recipe a try. So without any further delays, let's look into the ingredient list now. My first ingredient is of course some mushrooms. And today I'm going to use some button mushrooms, around 500 grams. For the spices today I have 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of chaat masala, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala powder, 1 teaspoon of kasuri methi powder, 2 teaspoons of roasted gram flour or besan, salt to taste, 3 tablespoons of yogurt or curd, 1 tablespoon of ginger paste, 1 tablespoon of garlic paste, around 3 tablespoons of butter, 2 tablespoons of white oil, 2 tablespoons of coriander leaves chopped finely, and juice of 1 lime. And our star ingredient today is again Patak tikka masala, and finally 1/2 cup of fresh cream. For this recipe, we'll be doing it in 2 steps. First, we'll marinate the mushrooms and cook them. And then we'll go into making the gravy. So we'll start off by preparing the marinade for the mushrooms. For that, we'll start off with the yogurt. Next to this, I'm going to add in the ginger and garlic paste. Around 1 tablespoon of white oil, red chili powder, chaat masala, turmeric powder, salt to taste, and gram flour or besan, and juice of 1 lime. Mix all the ingredients well to prepare the marinade. After mixing all the ingredients well, we'll add in the mushrooms in the marinade. Mix the mushrooms well with the ingredients. If you want, you can use your hands for this also. And here are my mushrooms well coated with the marinade, and we'll keep this aside for at least 30 minutes before starting to prepare the dish. It's been 30 minutes now, and so we'll start off by preparing the mushroom tikkas first. So for that, I'm going to add in the rest of the oil, that is around 1 tablespoon of oil, along with 2 tablespoons of butter. To this, we are going to add in the marinated mushrooms. We are going to cook the mushrooms on high heat till they are around 70% done. Remember to cook your mushrooms on high heat always so that they don't turn soggy. It will take approximately 5 to 7 minutes. And keep stirring in between. It's been around 7 minutes now, and my mushrooms are around 70% cooked. So I'm going to remove them from heat now. First, switch off the gas and remove it from heat. And this is how my mushrooms should look once they are done. In the same pan, I'm going to add in the rest of my butter, that is around 1 tablespoon. If you want, you can use white oil instead too, but as Indian dishes are pretty rich and they are usually cooked in butter or ghee, which is clarified butter. Once my butter melts, I'm going to add in the jar of my Patak tikka masala. I'll add in a little bit of water in my jar and add it to the gravy. Give it a good mix. And let the gravy come to a boil. As you can see, my gravy has come to a boil. I'm going to add in the mushrooms to it now. Mix it well with the gravy, and I'm going to cover it and cook it for at least 3 to 4 minutes. It's been around 4 minutes now, and my mushrooms are well cooked. At this point, I'm going to add in the garam masala powder. and kasturi methi powder. Mix it well. And I'll add in around half teaspoon of sugar. This is completely optional. If you like your tikka masala on the sweeter side, then add it. Otherwise, you can omit this. And finally, we'll add in around half cup of cream. Give it a good mix. After adding the cream, we'll cook it for another 2 minutes before serving. My mushroom tikka masala is ready, and I'm going to sprinkle some coriander leaves on top before serving. And I'll switch off the gas now. My mushroom tikka masala is ready. It smells divine, and it is a must try for all vegetarians out there. And on that note, I'm going to end my video here. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button.